What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to the channel. This is the RTH Podcast, man. I'm your host, Nephew, and I'm checking in, man. So, seems like Tim Tszyu is now the favorite leading up into the long-anticipated Undisputed Showdown at the 154 division, which is the junior middleweight division, or some might say the super welterweight division. And he's favored by Sean Porter, a gentleman who should see the Hall of Fame shortly. I kind of agree with him to a certain degree, and here's my reasons before we get into Sean Porter's reasons. I just think that there's only so many times you can curse somebody out. You know what I'm saying? There's only so many times you can call somebody the B word or the P word and, you know, call out your financial gains. Oh, I got more money than you. And it'd be funny and it'd be reasonable and the whole nine. There's only so many times you can do that before people start saying, bruh, when you gonna fight? You know what I'm saying? Like, we can have all these other conversations about how you better than him, and how he's a less of an opponent, and how he's not that good of a fighter. We can have all those conversations while y'all setting up a fight. You see what I'm saying? And on one hand, this is Jermell Charlo's tour. You know, you went undisputed. You go on a tour, man, of dominating the division. You know, we can say what we want to say about Devin Haney and the Vasily Lomachenko fight. That was one of those toss-ups for him. But he went on his tour. He won undisputed, and he went on a two-fight defense tour before he decided to maybe go up to 140 or maybe come back down. He don't know what he's going to do right now. But as far as Jermell Charlo, he's been injured. His entire tour, he's been injured. We haven't been able to see him. And because he's sitting in the king chair without the championship goals being up for grabs or being defended, it makes the division dead. It does. And the 154 division wouldn't be nothing right now without Tim Tszyu. So with that being said, two fights this year, unnecessary fights at that. He didn't have to fight Tony Harrison or Carlos Ocampo. Shout out to both of those guys for stepping to the ring with Tim Tszyu. But he didn't have to fight those guys. He could have waited on Jermell Charlo. But if he would have waited on Jermell Charlo, we wouldn't have no big 154 fights to talk about, with the exclusion of Sebastian Fundora and Brian Mendoza. That would be the only thing we could really talk about that happened in 154 this year. So kudos to Tim Tszyu for staying active and getting two KOs. And those, bruh, the last one with Ocampo, bruh, I said, man, it's going to go 7-9. 7-9 rounds, he's going to knock out Ocampo. But I didn't understand how Ocampo would even be able to go that far because of how his feet is just cemented to the ground. And the craziest scenario, bruh, 77 seconds. And he went to sleep. So, yeah, man, I kind of favor Tim Tszyu as well to beat Charlo. It's not by a lot, but, yeah, man, Charlo got to show up, man. You got to stop talking, Charlo, and give us what we're looking for, bruh. Or, you know, relinquish the titles and go out like that. But it is what it is. I heard somebody saying that it was a possibility of him seeing Canelo Alvarez. That's not going to happen. That's a lie. Canelo Alvarez cannot fight Jermell Charlo. He could fight Jamal, but he can't fight Jermell for a two-time undisputed. Reason being is because the WBO has already said that they have to fight by September the 30th with Jermell Charlo and Tim Tszyu. So they're going to strip him possibly prior to him even getting into the Canelo fight if he were to take that fight. More than likely. So, yeah, I don't think that he's going to get a chance to fight Jermell Charlo in Canelo Alvarez. Saying that to say, we're going to get on what Sean Porter had to say. And I'm going to wrap this thing up for you guys. So, so many words. Sean Porter was talking to a reporter. I guess he was in the building for the Ocampo-Tim Tszyu fight. And this is what he had to say. He said, this is a big problem for Charlo. Look at all of this momentum on the side of Tim Tszyu. Tim Tszyu has so much to talk about when they go into press conferences, and Jermell Charlo has to keep his mouth shut because Charlo hasn't been busy. What can he talk about? Nothing. Guess what? Everything is on Tim's side to win this fight. I even guarantee that even from the standpoint of bookies, if bookies don't put Tim Tszyu as the favorite, then they're just favoring Charlo. Tim Tszyu is now the favorite to win and become undisputed. Now, he had a lot to say in this article, so if you guys want to check that out, then you have to go find it. But it is what it is in that aspect. I agree. One guy hasn't been fighting, the other guy has. It's not a wide margin, if you were to ask me. I actually do think that Jermell Charlo is that good, but with the long layoff, with kinda, can't say that he is, but with kinda looking like he's avoiding the situation, I really think that he hoped that somebody else would beat Tim Tszyu. I could be wrong about that. But he seemed as though like the guy ain't that good. Well, if he ain't that good and he's number one, don't knock him off. Like, that's how I look at it. It might not be the largest payday for you, but at least you will be in the clear to do what you want to do with your career, and right now you're not. So that puts Jermell Charlo in kind of the hot seat to really go out there and have to put on possibly the best performance of his career in order to beat a very tough and a very game Tim Tszyu. Tim Tszyu does have a lot of power and could definitely dominate this fight if necessary. I don't know what they're going to go through within the next few months, but they have it to September the 30th, says the WBO, or they're going to step in. And when they step in, they're just going to take the belt. I'm pretty much tired of dealing with Jermell Charlo's BS. Now, no offense to him, and he had a hand injury. I'm pretty sure it's clear, though. Why wouldn't it be clear by now? When Jesse Bam Rodriguez broke his jaw this year. He broke his jaw this year, and he's already in conversations to fight Sonny Edwards. So I don't see what's the difference between a jaw being broken and a fist being broken. I don't know. I would think the jaw would take a lot longer, but I could be wrong about that. I'm not a medical physician, so I can't say. But yeah, this is a good one, bro. I do favor Tim Tszyu right now. It's not by a large margin, but I do think that right now Tim Tszyu is the fighter of the year, in my opinion. Excuse me. But I do think he's the fighter of the year. He's only tied with Tank Davis, in my opinion. So they would be number one and number two. Or you can call them both number one right now. But with Tim Tszyu being able to see the ring ASAP, and Tank Davis having to wait, excuse me. And with Tank Davis having to wait, I don't see Tank being considered fighter of the year by the end of the year, and Tim Tszyu will get it. Because he's already on fight number three. Everyone else in the sport of boxing is on fight number two. Canelo Alvarez, number two. Devin Haney would be on number two. Progreus, number two. You have Jerron Ennis stepping into the ring right now for his number two versus Romain Vila, who also has his number two fight. Tank Davis has two knockouts, though, and so does Tim Tszyu. So if Tank could get back into the ring and knock out his third opponent, it still wouldn't be for Undisputed, but it would put him in a position to be considered at least number two on the Fight of the Year card, maybe. A lot of you guys are big Spences and Crawford fans, and you're saying, oh man, they're going to be the Fight of the Year. No, they're not, in my opinion. No, they're not. They haven't fought nobody. It's only been one fight. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is in that aspect. I don't know, man. Hopefully Charlo can be a little bit more cool in the negotiations to get the fight done as far as the money is concerned. I know he's probably going to be a headache when it comes to getting the money involved, because he's already been playing that I got more money than you card. So it's possibly going to be very difficult for Tim Tszyu to get him to sign for anything less than what he's looking for. So maybe like a 60-40. Or maybe even a 70-30. It's possible because it's undisputed. And would he be wrong? No. He wouldn't be wrong to make the money advantage on his side, because it's a dangerous fight. But to put the money on his side and then win it, that would be crazy, because Tim Tszyu don't get the payday that he's looking for, as well as don't get the belts. So Tim's going to have to come out very game and ready to go. I have a lot of ideas about this fight and how it would take place, but I'm gonna keep it to myself, man, because I don't want people using my talking points. So I'm not gonna really do the side by side as to how I see these two gentlemen fight. Just gonna keep those things to myself. But this is the RTH podcast, man. I'm your host, Nephew, and I'm signing out. Y'all let me know who y'all see winning this particular showdown when it goes down, man. They got until September the 30th, so that's tail end of the summer, leading into the fall. And if they don't get it done by then, we'll see what the WBO will do about the situation. But right now, he's the favorite. I can agree to that. And yeah, man, I'm not taking that back until we know what Charlo gonna do. But this is the RTH Podcast, your host, Nephew, signing out. Y'all take it easy, bruh. Peace.